Thank you very much for joining us, Stormwatch 9 Weather on the Web, tracking more impact weather before we get to our weekend. So the timing actually for Saturday, Sunday are looking good. Not good if you have tomorrow off and you're going to be traveling across the state. Be prepared for a shower during the morning, maybe an isolated rumble of thunder, but then downpours and scattered thunderstorms that may contain strong wind gusts, frequent lightning, and even some hail, a potential in the afternoon and evening hours, even some localized flooding, mostly in the western part of the state. So when we take a look at our flash flood threat level, it's a 1 on a scale of 1 to 4, anywhere from Berlin down to the Mount Washington Valley, central eastern lakes region, lower part of the Merrimack Valley, and east to about Rochester, Dover, and Durham, and right to about, say, Epping. However, to the west, it's a level 2, so the greatest chance of flooding will be in areas from the Monadnock region through the Lake Sunapee area, up to a good portion of Grafton County, from Plymouth through Lincoln, all the way back through Franconia Notch, up to Whitefield, and back through the Upper Valley. So a better shot of some localized flash flooding issues during the afternoon and evening on your Friday. So here's that storm that we're tracking back into the Great Lakes. Out ahead of it, the center of circulation, numerous severe thunderstorm warnings, even tornado warnings during early on Thursday evening. So tomorrow, the severe threat in terms of damaging winds and or large hail is relatively low, but it's not zero, and this could actually increase to a level 2. So just be prepared for that and be storm aware on your Friday afternoon and evening. So that's our timeline. Coverage of storms that may produce damage, more isolated, but downpours, gusty winds, and hail, all the potential, along with frequent lightning and any storm that moves in. So here's a look at the timeline for your Friday. There could be a shower, a thunder shower during the morning hours, and then from around midday into the early afternoon, could even be some bright spots here or there. From around 3 o'clock on to about 9 or 10 in the evening, that's when we could see some strong storms popping up basically anywhere, especially from the White Mountains on south. And that's when you have to really be ready to seek shelter as any storm moves through. Then, later in the evening, all of that is gone. Skies begin to clear out. Your Saturday, partly sunny, could be a pop-up shower or thunderstorm north, otherwise dry south, and then even more sun as we go into Sunday and Monday. So really a nice stretch of weather outside of tomorrow. So again, temperatures in the 70s due to more clouds, humidity ramping up quite a bit, but then it turns less sticky as we go into Saturday. And on Sunday, pleasant temperatures, sun and clouds with a pop-up shower or thunderstorm up north on Saturday, and lots of sun as we go into Sunday. Monday, full sun as well, few clouds possibly late, and then another chance of some scattered storms, mostly during the afternoon on your Tuesday before it dries out again.